Alright, and welcome back to Snack Play Love, where today we are going to be doing something a bit different, a bit weird. I had a deck which I quite liked back in Standard, based around the card Drakehame. Whenever you cycle or discard a card, you may pay one. If you do, create a 2/2 blue Drake creature token with flying. This was probably my favourite cycling payoff in the original Amonkhet block, and it led to some good decks which I took to game days and earned promos and victories and whatnot. But while I could have built it when the Amonkhet set came out, there was a few key cards that were in my version which were hangovers from the previous block, which was Kaladesh, namely things like Glimmer of Genius, where you don't really care about the energy, but Scry 2, Draw 2 is very good. Fumigate, which was the best sweeper when you got a billion drakes on the battlefield. You gain life for all those drakes, and suddenly you just start making them in the end of their turn, and you're happy. This isn't the perfect game day version, purely because I've added in two modern lands and these invasion block lands. For the purposes of this video, though, I think I'm going to take those out. I've undenard. See, we had extra blue-white, because it's a blue-white deck, but it's got a little bit of black and green in because you want the extra cards that are cycling. The version of the deck which is built here, which is the one I was playing with my friend quite recently at work, has less than 10 cards in without a cycling ability or the ability to cycle themselves. But what we're going to do... I thought that would... why is it not letting me do that? We'll do it the old-fashioned way then. It will give us the opportunity to put some red ones in as well. No, we need to play the ones that we haven't collected. Do excuse my inability to do anything in the interface. I think we'll have one of each of those, purely because... I want options for when I use these cards for other things. So we're going to take out the Secluded Steps, which I crafted for a different reason. So now we're on 58 cards. We take out the Triomes as well. I can't remember why we preferred the Deserts. I think there was a payoff for the Deserts that I had, which I no longer have. I suppose it's just extra on-colour cycling lands, isn't it? And because they're commons, I'm going to... in fact, I've already got those, so that's cool. Boom. So, we're at 58. We'll have another Irrigated Farmland and another Fetid Pools. So, as it stands, that's 39 wild cards. So, ideally we wouldn't be cashing in 39 wild cards at one point for a speculative deck, because we haven't got any Scattered Groves, have we? No. Ideally, we're going to replace a lot of this straight away. We've got our counter-cycling, we've got our Exile Enchantments, we've got some life gain, we've got four Drakehavens, we've got a Kefnet, purely because it was in my original deck. I think I wanted to play the God because I opened it, so I put it in. We've only got one Nimble Obstructionist, because at the time, I only had one Nimble Obstructionist. Since that point, I've got a second one, which I've put in the sideboard, along with some of the things we're going to try out that I either never had at the time or didn't exist at the time. It's one of the reasons for wanting some red lands, because if we've got some white, red, and white, blue lands, then blue, red, we can get there. None of those lands overlap with the things that we have, do they? That's unfortunate. Yeah, never mind. Anyway, it's not like we're short on wild cards. So, yeah. Does that eat half of our rare wild cards? Almost. Fine. Boom. I just forgot. I needed to take the things out the sideboard so it didn't craft those as well. But we've crafted those for the future now anyway, so hooray. So now we have a mildly competitive, probably not though, deck. We, in theory, have the splash so that you can lay claim things, and because there was a lot of activated abilities around at the time, you could activate those activated abilities using your off-colour lands that you've kept in your deck for mostly for cycling reasons. But let us try and see what happens. Let me check that I'm still recording. We are indeed. I'm not going to try standard ranked. Well, it would be historic ranked anyway, but there it is. And as you can see, this is genuinely the first time I've played this deck on Arena, apart from a few casual games against some very soft decks in for what we call our substandard league at work. I have not played this in years. So, Drakehaven doesn't have a cycling ability, so you can't actually cycle your... I apologise for all of the stream raiders noises in the background. I think I'm not going to start any more matches. So, we're against some generic life gain. We definitely want to have blue-white happening. So I think we're going to just... Fumigate could save us. Do we need to keep the fourth land? Not sure. I can't remember how it works. I know we've got 26 lands in the deck. So we cycle that, we get an effect for cycling it. We may gain 2 life. We do gain 2 life, and now we can draw 2 cards. This is good. Counter target spell unless its controller pays 1. So we can play... why would we play the thicket? Play that. I'm going to Drakehaven out at the moment, presuming that this deck has nothing that is perfect on 3 that we need to counter. I can't remember. Helios, yeah, we should have given 5 cents. Never mind. I think that's us losing the game now. But it is fine. We're practicing. We're getting used to it. I wish you could cycle that and draw 1 card. Wait, that's what cycling does. That's more on colour than that, so we'll play that tapped. And then pass the turn. I mean, I don't think they'll just swing in with the 2-2. They aren't going to just swing in with a 2-2, but we are going to counter that. So, the problem with playing Sensor is you need to know what your opponent's decks are. We have to take 6, because unlike the other cycling cards, you can't just make a token, you have to pay for it. So you have to pay for the cycling ability and the thing. So we're looking for an untapped land here, so we are going to cycle that. Can't pay. Won't pay. So that's our second cycling payoff, the curator. I am going to put it out. The reason for playing Kefnet, by the way, is it's his second ability. Draw a card, then you may return a land you control to its owner's hand. Bouncing the lands with cycling to your hand is ridiculously good. So, they have taken the incorrect thing. I'm so happy. We can exile Vanishing Light or Heliod. I don't think I've cycled one of those like an idiot. No, I haven't. That's quite cool. Maybe they were stuck on land. That's interesting. So, we haven't got any good cycling one. It's a risk playing out, but I'm gonna... No! I was going to play that as a land, I'm an idiot. But now we've got a lot of payoffs. That is intriguing. Oh, he didn't realise he could attack. Well, that's quite nice. Because we cycled that land, we're now struggling. What's he going to cast for four from two cards that's going to cause us a problem? All of these cyclings are instant. I think we have to cycle Curator of Mysteries at this point. Mind you, we can cycle the sensor card. So if we cast something that costs all of his mana, we probably have to counter it. He's paying two to draw a card. Let us see what they target with that. We haven't got the Nimble Obstructionist. We probably do want to fly. So the Soul Warden ability is going to be very frustrating. But all of these are things we can get back. We have to block one of them, so we'll block the large one. Realistically, we need to find another one of our boards. Irrigated Farmland just is not going to cut it. We need three drakes from two lands, so we're going to have to block with the Vizier. Although we can use it to untap a land. She's making things happen. See what he attacks with. Everything was my guess. Oh, that's fine. We can deal with that. So probably want to keep that. Yeah, that's the problem. It makes everything bigger. Cast out. Non-land permanent. We don't have enough mana to do that now. Single block. This combo might just be too powerful for us. I don't know that we survive the attack though. Blocked there and there and there. And we're taking three. No, I think we just move on. So we're learning the deck again. There's a lot more. Because don't forget this is essentially a standard deck, not a historic deck. We need to be able to match things against old standard. Right. How weird. I thought you could pause. On the old version of OBS, I could pause what I was doing. The audio seemed a lot better on that version as well, which is odd. I genuinely don't know what's going on. Anyway, let's try another game just for demo purposes. I don't think that was an unwinnable matchup by any stretch. We've got cast outs and the exile and enchantments, which would have dealt with most of his board. But because we're essentially a weird deck, we don't always find our answers. Of course, we don't always find our opponent. Just going to place some Stream Raider units while they figure themselves out. I really should set it up so that you could see what I'm doing. No, they're still there. Also, we could pause the because when people take forever to start the games, we would often just hit pause until our hand selection algorithm kicked in. It's very weird. Maybe the Streamlabs OBS doesn't have the flexibility that the hardcore programmer OBS does. So, in theory, I don't want to play my irrigated farmland. I don't know where they are. More rumbles. But I might use it as... Oh, here we go. As soon as I find something to show you. They upsed and clearly forgotten they'd started a game or they were having a problem. I've started games and it kicks me out. It's fine. Let us show them that we're a blue deck. We don't actually have any payoffs, so... still don't have any payoffs. Does, but this is one of the reasons that I think the we don't have anything that costs three. Oh, we do. We only have Kefnet, and they're going to counter that. Do we care that much about Kefnet? I'd rather have the curator down. Let's see what they're not playing counters. Oh, that's amazing. God, please, death touch it. So we played three lands, activated three abilities, and we still have six cards in hand. This is important. You will see why. Surveil two, draw card. Interesting. That must mean they're not rogues, they're graveyard. Is this indestructible? It is. Nice. Now we have seven cards in hand. Kefnet can attack. Play a land for the turn. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, because we'll draw. Maybe this is why Kefnet's in the deck. Maybe I just forgot why he's in the deck. Because we're not holding up counters particularly. But at the start of our next turn, we'll have six cards in hand. Hieroglyphic Illumination. There we are. Let's have a look what he's got before he returns them. That looks like it's a self-mill deck. He's milled two Drakehavens. Okay, we're winning through the creature room. So, Kevin can attack again. We want more white sources, really, don't we? Again, we've only gone down to six, so they now need to sweep, bounce, destroy the curator. I mean, sometimes this deck is just flyer aggro. Ooh, what's it returning? Because we haven't seen any creatures yet. No creatures! Oops. Okay, the reanimator deck failed to animate. Our first victory with Drakehaven. Hooray! Let me celebrate by again, I'll flick to OBS so I can see what the hell I'm doing. Ah, actual magic cards. See, it's a real deck, honest. I've got a picture of the deck spread out, which I might try and use as the thumbnail, but I think that'll just confuse people when they click on it and it's a real video. I just tried to click on the card on the view. Let's play best of three. Let's see what happens. But as you can probably tell, the land base is not optimal. Those lands we took out that we could have cycled for one mana would have meant that instead of having a load of things in our hand that we pay two to cycle, we only pay one to cycle them. And that means that we can afford Drakes much more often. And much more often. And this deck tends to operate at the end of the other person's turn, so having four mana up, you could be cycling four things, you could be drawing two cards, you could be doing absolutely anything, and they genuinely don't know. The cast out is flash, the gain life, the gain six life is instant. It works quite well. I genuinely can't remember whether I won a game day with it or not. It was during the end of the time when I cared about constructed magic. I think it was properly my last real constructed deck. There was one with allies after this, to be honest. But that set isn't on Arena yet, which is weird. But they'll get there. They'll figure it all out eventually. I know that... Oh, no, the no cards thing. This is locked. This is failing miserably. I don't think our internet has failed. No, Stream Raiders is still playing. What do you reckon? Do we quit out? I reckon we quit out. Not concede. No, not the other one. Genuinely don't know what will happen on Streamlabs. Oh, looking for a game to capture. That's what will happen. What an interesting little grey box I live in. That'll probably be the thumbnail for the video. That's how YouTube curses and hates us. I'm actually having to use mobile broadband today for some reason. But usually that's faster than the home broadband for upload, but slower for download. But not by much. Do we get to see our cards? Oh, there's a heartbeat. It's them. It's their problem. We didn't need to reboot the client. See how I auto kept that to put the pressure on them. We've got Glimmer, which... Oh, no, yeah. Scat can cycle, as can they. The important thing about these is they cycle for colourless. Whereas the other one, you have to pay a colour to cycle. Okay, so we're going to be looking to... See, I'm wondering why we don't have any desert payoffs in the deck. straight up exile creature effects. I want to keep the illumination this time. Looking to do Cat Oven Draining, but with Anointed Priest shenanigans as well. Well, the rule is we don't have any payoffs, so we're cycling stuff. I am going to cycle a land, which is stupid and risky, but I don't think we need the Scattered Groves particularly in this build of the deck. Now we've got multiple cycles up. Vizier of Tumbling Sands is a blue ramp card. It's not supposed to be. It probably should say non-land permanent. But you can do quite a weird stuff with it, like what's that new land? The one I've got all the cards from, the Lotus Field. If you were to untap a Lotus Field by cycling Vizier of Tumbling Sands, you would not only have drawn a card, but you would be up a mana. If the Vizier's on the battlefield and tapping it, you're up 3 mana. It's a very odd thing. We're going to need to fumigate at some point now. Oh, shall we? Ooh! In my head, those are so the wrong way around. There is a way to get cycling cards back from the graveyard. Not currently playing it in this version, but it might be interesting. And there's also Zerda from the new set, who in theory, if you take Drakehaven out of the Drakehaven deck, which would make me very sad, you can... and you have to take out things like Fumigate because they don't have an activated ability. Yes, I think you do. I think it, or is it all permanents have to have an activated ability? Anyway. Then you can basically cycle everything for one less once you've got Zerda out. It means the deck has to be more white. Why would they always have a copy of the thing? We just spend money to stay. So now, cats, cats, cats. They're not interested. Okay. Two cards on my turn, or draw one card on your turn. Choose. It's good, yes? Haha. So, we've got two shots of getting a land. We need a white land, to be honest. And I cycle the white land. Both of these are options. Chances of them finding a third Bontu's Monument, slim. I think we'll just go for it. It's not an ETB effect, so it's not a good Aristocrat ability. Catocrat. We're not going to be cycling Fetid Pools this turn. So I think we just play into it. We do want to cycle a 2-mana thing to combo. We kind of want to destroy the oligarch before. So I'm not sure whether he would have got stuff from Bontu's Monument on that. Cast a creature spell. Again, that is going to cause me problems. He's saying he doesn't need to attack. So. See what we get before we decide. Yes, we will. See, all of this should be me making drakes for cheap, but it is not. We want to get rid of that bastion before we wipe the board, because they're out of cards. I don't know why it tapped both white for that. Now we'll take the blind cards. Those don't do what we actually said we were looking for. It's a Kevnet there. We can cast Kevnet, by the way, because we can untap a land, but he can't attack or block, so he's indestructible there. They haven't been attacking, they have the ability to sacrifice one thing a turn. I don't think anything they cast can be possibly better. As in, I don't think Sense will work against anything they're doing. So they have the sack triggers for the cat oven thing, which they're going to do at the end of my turn and get a bunch of life. But in theory, if we can cycle into something that removes the bastion. So that's cast. So that died and triggered it, until it triggers off itself. Does kill itself. Okay. So we definitely wouldn't have been able to censor this turn. Now they've got two Cauldron Familiars and only one Cauldron. They know they can attack through Kefnet, which is interesting. Drakehaven, okay. Does that mean we're just in a better position to rebuild than they are? I think it does. I know we lose a shed load of life due to this. Nimble Obstruction is the counter on some of these things would be fantastic. So things die, we lose a shed load of life. But we gained our shed load as well. Left life one. I thought there was more than that. Desert of the True. So he can bring one back with the pie. If he's got anything that costs five. It's an ability, so we can't counter it, can we? Some theoretical one mana sense, and some actual one mana cyclones. We'll keep sensor up for the moment. Because cycling that's paid to untap one, so it's never. Sanctuary. See, that would be a beautiful thing to counter with sensor, but we can't. Fortunately, we are going to do combat damage too. A massive struggle, to be honest. It really is. Yeah, when his creatures die, we will get killed. I think we cycle play the sensor now to see what happens. Before. That's funny. I don't think we used the sweeper too early. I don't think we could have done much else. We didn't see the things to remove their problematic enchantments after we'd used two of them, that is. So, right. Well, anyway, thanks for watching. I hope the audio is not too bad on this version. Please comment, subscribe, etc., because that helps the channel for the YouTubers and the blah blah blahs. But otherwise, go away. Bye.